think somebody got a peek at my notes maybe before I got up here. Good evening, everyone. First, I want to offer my sincere congratulations to the other inductees this evening. That is certainly being inducted amongst a very impressive group. Dad rarely made speeches, but I know that he would have been elated to be here this evening making this speech. It would have been a huge sense of accomplishment for him to know he's being inducted into the Nova Scotia Business Hall of Fame. And to be there with a number of friends and business associates. Many of you in the audience this evening knew Dad very well, colleagues, friends, family. You folks are very familiar with many of the details, so the rest of the speech is to try and give a sense of who Dad was to the remainder of the audience and why he's such a worthy inductee. Dad liked to get things done, so much so that in 1963, when asked by his grade 9 teacher why he wasn't in school, he responded by telling her, "Look, I'm really too busy to be at school." At the time of the conversation, he was sitting on top of his old D4 dozer, which you've heard, digging the basement for the Angus L. McDonald Library at St. Evex University. That was his first big contract. From its beginning in the fall of 1963, Nova Construction went on to become one of the leading general contractors in the region. Some of the largest civil construction projects in the Maritimes were built by Nova. The Rec Cove Hydroelectric Project, the Cobequid Pass, the Antigonish Bypass, along with hundreds and hundreds of kilometers of roads and bridges built across the Atlantic provinces. I know he took great pride in building projects that would last and stand the test of time. Dad got great enjoyment from simple things like moving dirt. This was his passion. He enjoyed seeing projects take shape and was always very proud of the work that Nova was part of. He was even more proud of the men and women that worked with Nova over almost six decades to make those projects happen. Dad had a great ability to find great people and then let them do exactly what they were hired for. He employed great, capable individuals, and in turn, they did great things. In addition to moving dirt, Dad also had some other significant projects as well. The development of the Porcupine Mountain Quarry, concrete services, a ready-mix concrete supplier, the owning and expansion of the Antigonish Mall, building and operating Riverside Speedway, which is still considered one of the finest racing venues in the country. Pioneer Coal, another company within the Nova Group, spent 42 years cleaning up derelict former mine sites and providing cost-effective energy to the people of Nova Scotia. Nova and associated companies have always been based in rural Nova Scotia. He took great delight in that fact. I would say most of his employees over the years also came from rural parts of Nova Scotia, especially northern Nova Scotia and Cape Breton. He was able to grow businesses in parts of the region that many people grow up in, but often leave when given the chance. It's not an easy task to grow a big business in a small town. Outside of his building and creating career, I think one of the things that made him so special were his acts of giving. Giving came in many forms for Dad, some monetary, but in other cases, it was mentoring others that needed a hand or some advice on how to navigate business challenges. His philanthropy included significant donations to the IWK Hospital Foundation, to the Cody Institute at St. Evex, but also to the thousands of smaller donations he made to local and regional charities, whether it was a tank of oil for somebody in need, supporting the local food bank, or donating to the various grassroots clubs and organizations in the region. None of these things were done for praise or appreciation. I know that in many cases, these things were done under the specific instruction that no public acknowledgement ever be made. Dad did not look at giving for the publicity. He gave because he knew it was needed. So now for a few thank yous. First, I want to say a special thank you to my mom, Anne, who stood by Dad the entire way. I know she was a big part of his success, and I'm quite certain she was quietly his biggest supporter. Secondly, I want to thank everybody in the room tonight that has worked with, helped, advised, or been part of this journey with Dad. I'm sure you could all tell some interesting stories, and maybe we'll hear some of those later. And lastly, I sincerely want to thank Junior Achievement of Nova Scotia for recognizing Dad and inducting him into the Nova Scotia Business Hall of Fame. It truly is an honor for our family. It will be a proud moment to see his portrait hanging in the hall among so many other successful and distinguished men and women. Thank you.